Picture this. It's the 90s. You stop at a red light in your Ferrari, chilling and flexing in your car. A few moments later, a red and kind of awkward looking car pulls up next to you. You rev your Ferrari to make a statement. Light turns green and boom, you're left in the dust in your Ferrari. You, my friend, have just been surpassed by an Acura NSX and your life will never be the same again. Firstly, what is this name? NSX. Did Acura just found some random alphabets and arrange them in a way to sound cool? Or is there an actual reason behind it? Well, there is. The NSX was an experiment done by Honda towards making a lightweight, fun-to-drive, rear-wheel sports car, and thus the name New Sports Car Experimental. But still, the question is, how did the idea of a sports car suddenly emerge at Honda? Well, the origins of the NSX track back to the 1984 HPX, Honda Pininfarina Experimental. Yes, one of the sickest collaborations ever, proving the fact that collaborations have resulted in better cars than rivalries will ever produce. Honda committed to the project with the intention of meeting or exceeding the performance of the then V8 engine Ferrari range while offering reliability and a lower price point. Gordon Murray, the designer of the McLaren F1 supercar, stated that he used the NSX as an inspiration for the F1 after test driving many high performance cars available at that time and finding the NSX chassis performed the best. Murray stated that the design was monumental to sports car design. He found that the car could easily have handled more power and attempted to convince Honda to develop a more powerful engine, but Honda declined. This resulted in Murray developing the F1 with a BMW, but he was so fond of the NSX that he bought one for personal use and drove it for 75,000 kilometers. Murray stated that the NSX was very dear to his heart. I would just like to pause for a moment here and say something. Cars like the Acura NSX, the Ferrari F40, McLaren F1 are some of the best cars ever made, and they have been made due to understanding and collaboration between manufacturers, not by producing rivaling cars against each other. Honda is a manufacturer that likes to challenge other car manufacturers by making cars that cost fraction of the segment leading cars while still having the performance to beat them up. In 1990s, Honda laid out the idea of making a car that would challenge the Italians, the Ferrari beater, and they did it very successfully with the Honda NSX. They marketed it in the American market under their sub-brand Acura as the Acura NSX. The Acura NSX was a rear-wheel drive sports car that had a punchy 3-liter V6 engine, and as for the performance, it was indeed a Ferrari killer, except the top-of-the-line V12 models like the Ferrari F50. The NSX was designed by a team led by chief designer Masahito Nakano and executive chief engineer Shigeru Uehara. It benefited from advanced aerodynamics and styling inspired by an F-16 fighter jet cockpit and input from the late Formula 1 world champion Ayrton Senna. During the final development stages, the NSX became the world's first mass-produced car to feature an all-aluminium body. It was powered by an all-aluminium 3-liter V6 engine, which featured Honda's VTEC variable valve timing and lift electronic control system developed in the 1980s. VTEC kicked in, yo! After almost 2 decades later, in December 2007, Acura announced plans to launch a NSX successor by 2010. Honda thought of reviving the NSX and thus they launched the Acura NSX yet again. And in 2020, it's available with all-wheel drive. As for the powertrain, it has a twin-turbocharged V6 engine with 3 electric motors coupled to it that in total generate a total of 573 horsepower. The Acura NSX was intended to be a sports car, but surprisingly, it's a supercar now, and that's even better. You see, Honda likes to challenge everyone. They created the Civic Type R to beat the Golf GTI by a huge margin. Similarly, for the NSX, which costs around $160,000, beats the Ferrari 488 Pista in acceleration. The company claimed figures are the same, but in real world, the electric batteries in the NSX provide it with a boost of power that helps it to launch like a rocket. 0 to 60 miles per hour in just 2.7 seconds to be precise. And that's much more faster than the Pista. In terms of design, I have to say that Honda has actually nailed it. It looks like a very expensive supercar. It's sharp, it's muscular, it's angry, and the perfectly smooth flowing lines from the front to the rear give it the ideal silhouette of a supercar. It has quad exhausts layout in the back that sounds good from the factory, unlike other supercars which are always in a dire need of exhaust upgrades. The Acura NSX has even a party trick. It's called the EV mode, in which you can drive smoothly along the roads without roaring that V6 down the streets. But it has a pathetic range of only 3 kilometers, and that's nothing in today's world. But it's ideal for getting silently into your neighborhood if you don't want to disturb your neighbors. The reason behind such a pathetic electric range is down to batteries. They are quite small and only function as to provide the acceleration boost while you are doing launch control. 476 pound-feet of torque is the total torque generated by the engine. It's a healthy amount when you start considering that the engine is relatively small at just 3.5 liters and is enough to get this car to a top speed of 191 miles per hour. But I'm pretty sure if Honda gave the NSX a power upgrade and made it lighter, the NSX might as well do more than 200 miles per hour. It's a very capable car. But it doesn't matter anyway, because in the real world, it will be very rare for an owner to take their car to such high speeds unless the owner is on the autobahn itself. From the outside, no one will be able to tell if the NSX is a Honda product, but the moment you sit inside the car, you totally get the feeling of driving something which is from a lower price range. They have made their efforts, no doubt, but for example, the paddle shifters in the car feel like a cheap operating joystick. In achieving the affordability, Honda has for sure overlooked on some of the things. For example, the materials used in the car literally feel very cheap. The side view mirrors feel like they might fall off if closed too hard. But even after taking all the good and the bad things into consideration, the good things outweigh the bad things by a huge margin. There is a reason why the Acura NSX is called the affordable 918. Because it is. It does all the things that the 918 does, but it does all those things at a fraction of the price. It doesn't match up to the 918 in terms of quality or exclusivity, but that's where the price difference comes in. At its price, I seriously do think that the NSX is a strong proposal. And for someone who wants to buy their first supercar, they should for sure drive the Acura NSX once, and I'm pretty sure they won't be disappointed. So guys, that's all for the Honda Acura NSX. We trust we were able to provide you with some value out of this video. So if you got some value out of this, then hit that like and subscribe button and comment down below what do you think of the Acura NSX. Also check out our podcast Shift with Motor Drift. We have some really great conversations about cars on a weekly basis. We are available on 7 of the biggest audio platforms in the world, so check them out in the description below. Other links to joining our community will be in the description below. So join the Motor Drift community and become a Motor Drifter. Till then, ciao.